Now that we have established the need for storage, let's see how we can actually store renewable energy. There are four main forms of energy storage. The first is mechanical energy storage, such as realized in hydropower stations. It is also possible to store energy in heat, for instance in molten salt reservoirs. And batteries are, of course, the best known devices to store electrical energies. Finally, it's also possible to store energy in chemical bonds, for instance in the form of hydrogen, which is created by the electrolysis of water. We will here shortly discuss mechanical and heat storage, while we explore battery storage and chemical storage in detail in the upcoming videos. Mechanical storage works by using potential energy. An example is the potential energy stored in water that is pumped to a height level that is not in equilibrium with its surroundings. This is used in hydropower stations and in so-called inverted lakes. Another example of mechanical storage is compressed air storage. In hydropower stations, water is pumped to a high altitude reservoir, for instance in the mountains, when excess energy is available. The energy can be retrieved by letting the water flow down again. In principle, this method can have a large cycle efficiency of around 80%. To calculate the amount of energy, we need to multiply the mass of water by the gravitation constant G and the height difference between the lake and the power generator, which is usually roughly located at the discharge level. The second example is the inverted lake, where there is a lower reservoir of water enclosed by the sea. In case of excess energy, the water is pumped out of the lake and the water level decreases down to, for instance, minus 40 meters. If energy is needed, water is allowed to flow back into the lake. This method again has a good cycle efficiency. However, the storage capacity is limited. The lake on this picture has a surface area of 40 square kilometers and its storage capacity is 20 gigawatt hour. Given an average PV power of 8 watt per square meter, this would cover the day-night cycle of around 200 square kilometer of PV cells. However, as of today, such an energy storage island only exists on the drawing board. A third form of mechanical storage is compressed air storage. Excess energy is used to compress air to higher pressures, and when energy is needed, you can release the built-up pressure to regain the energy. For such storage, often underground salt domes are planned to be used. Due to the temperature effects on compression and expansion, the storage capacity is more complex to calculate. In fact, to compensate for the cooling of the expanding gas, additional fuel is added to the generator. These conventional storage facilities can have reasonable cycle efficiencies of around 80%, but the capacity is limited and their availability depends on the geographic conditions. Hence, while these techniques might be used to cover for some of the daily fluctuations, they will certainly not have the capacity needed for seasonal storage. Besides mechanical storage, one may store excess energy in the form of heat. This is employed in concentrated solar power plants. The slide shows such a plant located in Spain. A huge array of mirrors reflects the energy of the sun to heat a receiver that is located at the top of the tower. This heat is used to power a generator. And to keep the generator running during the night, part of the heat warms up a large body of molten salt. This stored heat will then power the turbines during the night. Heat storage is also very much in need for residential applications. Here you see how the heated water, for instance produced by solar collectors, is stored in an underground thermal battery. The problem is that thermal storage has a very small energy density and requires an enormous volume.